hear about that new diss came out by Kendrick Lamar about Drake.
I hate the way that you walk, the way that you talk. I hate the way that you dress. I hate the way that you sneak this. If I catch flight, it's gonna be direct. We hate the bitches you fuck, cause they confuse themselves with real women. Then notice I said we, it's not just me, I'm what the culture feeling. How many more fairy tale stories about your life till we had enough? How many more black features till you finally feel that you're black enough?
What do y'all think about that?
What I think about it? I think Drake got his ass cooked. Kind of what I think.
It's a lot of unpack. It's a lot of unpack.
But I will say that Drake can bounce back. You know, don't write Drake off like this.
I've been saying this since Rick Ross this. Kendrick Lamar say the same thing. I hate the way you say nigga.
I hate the way that you walk, the way that you talk. I hate the way that you dress. Surprise, you wanted that feature request. You know that we got some shit to address. I even hate when you say the word nigga. But that's just me, I guess. Some shit just cringeworthy. You ain't even gotta be deep, I guess.
Bro, you cannot rap cornrows no more, bro. I'm tired of you taking our culture and taking it to your own block, dog.
What are you saying? He's a culture vulture?
It's like Toronto.
Are you saying he's a culture vulture?
It's not Toronto.
What are you talking about? It's like Drake is all for the culture.
Nah, he's sagging his pants and shit, man.
Oh, he's really sagging his pants?
Yeah, man.
Oh, shit.
It just seems like Drake tried too hard sometimes. Yeah, sometimes it seems like he tried too hard.
Well, Drake, I want to tell you this, Drake. I don't want to hear you say nigga no more.
Kendrick's words, not ours.
I'm riding with Kendrick. I said that the last few episodes.
You're riding with Kendrick.
I'm not going to say, you look.
Oh, what do you mean, hey, Caution?
Hold on.
What are you talking about? You can't back away now.
Hey, look.
You sound like you were riding with Kendrick too.
Let me explain.
Oh, okay.
Let me explain. I told y'all last video, I'm a big fan of Drake.
Oh, you like the R&B side of Drake?
Yeah, I like the R&B side of Drake.
You don't like the rap side?
And what did Kendrick Lamar say? What did he say?
He said he liked the melodies.
That's it. I don't want no rapping Drake. I want a nigga to sing to my bitch.
Oh, my God. Holy shit.
Look, you heard what Kendrick Lamar said?
Holy shit.
Not only that, Kendrick Lamar said, we got three goats. I see two motherfuckers kissing on stage. Who was he talking about on that?
There's three ghosts left, and I see two of them kissing and hugging on stage. I love them to death, and in 8 bars, I'll explain their phrase. It's nothing nobody can tell me. I don't want to talk on no celly. You know I got language barriers. It's no accent you can sell me. Your Cole and Ivory know I'm a selfish nigga. The crown is heavy. I pray they my real friends. If not, I'm YNW Melly.
I think it's obvious, right? He's talking about Cole and Drake and...
He says three ghosts, but yet I see two of them hugging and kissing on stage.
Ooh!
Definitely talking about Cole and Drake.
Oh, my God.
I mean, it's
hold on, T-Rex. J. Cole, y'all take that shit on the chin, son.
Shit, well...
You gotta take that shit on the chin.
He's taking it on the chin.
Gasu! You have no choice. You said it on stage.
But, like I say, Drake can always come back. Now, people, they're already willing to write him off, to say it's over, but we don't know if it's over.
Let's touch on some of them lines he said. He said, you signed to a nigga that signed to a nigga that signed to another nigga, applying that Drake is in a whole 360 deal.
Oh!
His paperwork right. Like, that's crazy.
Let's speak on percentage. Show me your splits. I'll make sure I double back with you. You were signed to a nigga that signed to a nigga that said he was signed to that nigga. Try cease and desist on a like that record. Oh, what? You ain't like that record?
Yeah, I heard that. I was like,
and you know, crazy because he was just saying that shit about Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He mentioned top.
He told that man, he say, let me see the split.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go on, hit the split because your pants might rip. Holy shit.
God damn.
And apparently he tried to apply that Drake sent the cease and desist letter because of the like that record. I guess he ain't like that shit. Like, it's like, oh, I'm suing y'all niggas, man.
I'm telling you, Drake just hired like 30 fucking ghostwriters and got 27 right now.
Kendrick Lamar say he looking for him.
Hey,
he's waiting for these ghostwriters.
Yeah, man. Look, he got 37 of them. Man.
Don't get me.
He's ready, bro.
Yeah.
Boy, so I don't even know who I'm battling right now. I'm going against AI, ghostwriter. Who I'm going against?
Bring all of them.
This nigga Drake.
Hell, bring J. Cole out. Bring J. Cole ass out.
Oh, J. Cole, you stay where you at, man. I still love you, dude. Hell nah.
J. Cole say you're going to take it on the chin. Well, take it on the chin.
What do y'all give this? What, What's the rate? This is this?
By far, for me, just compared to the others, easily 9 out of 10.
I just think
it's better than any of the other tracks that came out. And I listened to it. This is one of the few songs that just grew on me every listen. The first song, I was like, oh, it's solid, you know, this and that. Then I listened to it again. It's like, okay, this is actually good. By the third listen, I was like, damn, you know what? This is pretty strong. I'm not gonna lie.
I kind of like when it first came on, I ain't gonna lie, I turned that shit off. I said it was whack. But then
that's that Drake fan in you speaking.
That's that Drake fan in you speaking. I'm like, damn, why these dudes sound like that? But then I got to listen to it two times. I'm like, oh, I kind of dig that shit. You know what I'm saying? What's your rating is, Cairo?
Well, when I first listened to it, I thought, yeah, it's a cool record and stuff. It's just a warning shot. But then as I kept listening, I was like, his Lamar music aged like wine because it get better over time. So I was like, damn, this shit is a hard-ass record. Like, he got so many lines up in there to unpack and stuff. It's like, I give it about 7.5 out of 10.
Okay, because you Ryan Womack.
Yeah, because I really liked the Chris record. I liked the Rick Ross record. I thought that was pretty good. But I think 7.5 out of 10, I'll give it 7.5.
So I had to go higher simply because that's a complexity here that just wasn't with those other songs.
So, man, this is Caution Toons. Our time is up. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, we happy. Thank y'all for watching our last video.
Making our shorts a big success.
Shorts, big success. Check us out on TikTok. It's going to be the same name as our YouTube channel, Caution Toons TV. Check us out on that. Check us out on Facebook, same name, Caution Toons TV. Check us out on that shit. Show us some love over there. Comment, subscribe. I don't know how you gonna do it. Just do it. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, we gonna end this right here. We got our boy
Pyro, what up?
D-Rex.
Caution.
Y'all later. On the next one.
Caution Toons.